When we talked about the current moment, we talked about the ramping up of enforcement laws across the country, copycat laws of SB 1070 that are propping up all over the place, and not just around criminalization in terms of police and ICE collaboration, but also in terms of going after immigrants so they can't rent homes or rent apartments in communities across the country. In North Carolina, the highest number of 287G and secure communities agreements, that there's a lack of resources on the ground in these communities because they're being all put into the CIR, DC, push for CIR, and that really is a push for more enforcement and an institutionalizing of the enforcement that we're seeing in our communities already and what's happening in Arizona, and that we don't need to sell out our communities in order to fight for immigrant rights, and that with a real change is one in the streets and not in DC, and that we don't go to DC and lobby until we have the power on the streets and we build a movement.
My name is Carlos Garcia, I come from Arizona, from the Puente movement. And we're here at the Immigrant Rights, the Migrant Rights Assembly. It's a movement that we're hoping to start from below. We're really trying to go back to the basis, to start deciding for themselves what they want, what's gonna happen. I think a lot of us are tired from the decisions to be made in Washington without the consideration, without talking to the folks on the ground. So we're really discussing the different topics and ways in which we could create a movement that's real to the people, and that's what the communities really want.
How is the current situation in Arizona with the SB1070 and the Sheriff Arpaio coming to proceed with our raids on July the 30th? What's going on?
In the media, people have been saying that people are afraid. It's not true. Our community is ready to fight back. Hmm. We're organizing bodies of defense committees. We're going to be ready on July 29th. We'll be ready for Arpaio on July 30th. And we're gaining momentum. People around the country are supporting. And we're going to fight back 1070. And we're going to fight back against Arpaio. And I think the only way we could do that is really organizing our community.
But what kind of actions are you talking when you say self-defense? Are you talking about guns? Are you talking about organizing?
What is it? What we do is it's a non-violent movement. Communities need to organize themselves, be prepared in what they're going to do, whether it's going to be a legal strategy, a boycott strategy, a non-compliance strategy, or even civic engagement strategy. So in all the different ways that we could fight back, we're going to do it, but the only way we can start fighting back is if we're organized.
Are people leaving the state of Arizona?
It's a misconception to think that hundreds of people are leaving. Some are leaving. You can't blame them. It's a horrible situation we're living in. But the majority, most people are staying back and they're going to fight. They know if they move, if they leave from Arizona, that these laws and what's going on in Arizona is only going to follow them. So they're staying there. They're deciding to fight back. And we're going to organize them and hopefully push these laws back.
The anti-immigrant groups say that this is about national security and fighting crime. Do you believe that's the reason why Arizona is acting this way, the state?
I believe that might be what they think. We know that is not true. We know that crime in our communities is down. We know that the numbers that they spew and they say are not true.
What is it about that?
It's about racism. We really believe it's about racism. It's about, we know the people that wrote this law. They're part of the FAIR movement. The Anti-Defamation League has already termed them and said that they are hate groups. And these are the people that are writing these laws. We know it's hate. We know it's apartheid. It's just trying to divide people.
What can people around them do in order to help the Puente movement and all these organizations here?
On July 29th, we're going to have a National Day of Action, National Day of Noncompliance. They could join that, either coming to Arizona or hosting their own action in their town, in their city. But what we're telling folks is what you can do when folks ask us what they can do to help us is organize your own community. Organize against the criminalization, against our community. Organize against 287G, against secure communities, which are the same things as SB 1070. We obviously would love for people to come down. You could go on our website, altoarizona.com. They could look up, there's an application there. We obviously are being careful about how we do it, but we're encouraged. Good folks, good organizers to come down and help out. If there could be fundraisers, any sort of help that people can provide that they have to spare. But again, we'd like to really say that what people can do to help us out is organize their own communities and fight back against criminalization.
Absolutely, and what I see in this room is that most of the activists are very young people. And this is like a community that we're sleeping in some way and it's awakening. What else can you say about this whole movement of immigrant solidarity?
I think that the young people are tired. They're tired of allowing these failed mechanisms that we've seen in the past. We're tired of allowing Washington, D.C. And these mainstream organizations to decide what's happening for us. We're here to take a stand with respect to the work that's been done by the elders and the people before us. But again, stepping up, bringing that energy, and it's really exciting to see young people from all over the country ready to fight and ready to organize the community.
Last question, a little bit off the topic, but how much support have you guys received in Arizona from the Hispanic Congressional Caucus and other so-called Hispanic leaders?
There hasn't been much. I mean, it's what they've done in the media, but to actually come out to the community, talk to the community, it hasn't been there. They could be doing a lot more. They should be out there getting arrested and fighting this head on. So we obviously asking those folks to step up, because they really are leaders. If they want to be elected by the new generations, this is the time they're going to need to step up. We're not only going to remember our enemies, but we're going to remember our friends that didn't step up at this time.
And this issue is not only affecting Latinos or indigenous people, as some of us identify ourselves, but it's affecting everyone. And in that sense, are you guys getting support from other communities, African Americans, white people?
Yes, it's been amazing. I think more than ever, African American community is realizing this is about racism. This is how they're being treated the same as we are. We're all in this fight together. And I think these issues are really bringing the communities together. So yes, we do have a united front with faith, Asian, African American, progressive white folks that are helping out, that are supporting. So we are building a broad coalition to fight back racism.
So how confident are you that you guys are going to be victorious and defeat SB1070?
We might not be able to defeat SB1070, but if we raise enough awareness and people understand what's going on. Unfortunately, in Arizona, and the way that politics are working right now, Obama is not stepping it up. The Democratic Congress and Democratic Senate is not stepping up. Unfortunately, this is a political thing. And honestly, we might not be able to stop SB1070, but what we might be able to stop is SB1070 from spreading.
But even if the Department of Justice is saying that is going to file a suit against Arizona, you don't think that's going to change?
I mean, it's actions speak louder than words.
Right, it's just saying.
If it happens, that's great. It depends if they're going to decide to do it. From what we've heard, they're probably not going to do it, but if they do it, that's great.
So you're not relying on what they promise?
Exactly. We can't rely on promises. We did that the last couple of years, expecting President Obama to come in and save everyone. And unfortunately, maybe some people were disappointed. Some people knew this was going to happen. But we can't expect or depend on them to come and save us. We need organizers.
Some of the gains that our movement has made around sanctuary cities are being rolled back in different parts of the country, but that all of this repression is giving us an opportunity, because people are feeling it. They're feeling that they need to rise up and they need to escalate, that this is a huge opportunity that we're building in terms of momentum. What is our vision? That people are talking about families staying together, that people need to feel safe again, and that we need to reestablish personhood, that we're not criminals, and that we have human rights, and that we're right now the way we're being treated is not as human beings. Stopping the raids, closing detention centers, and taking the power back and empowering the affected communities that have been hit the hardest. And what are we already doing? There's a lot of work already happening around the country from in Arizona, people meeting in these barrio community meetings, talking about how they're going to protect each other. And even in the worst case scenarios, imagine this, people talking about, if I get taken away, can somebody please, you know, taking the power to take care of their children, and have people having those kinds of conversations in those communities. Also, work around rapid response networks from Providence, Rhode Island to Arizona to all different parts of the country when people are being harassed. In the South Bronx, using graffiti and art, you know, a big sign that they put that no human being is illegal, and creating sanctuary spaces where people are being informed of their rights and gonna stand together in solidarity. Woo! Oh.
Because we are here in solidarity with each other.
One, two,
three.
Solidarity.